And the fourth concern that we have is really a sort of a fundamental question of how we actually want to regulate our financial institutions, particularly on the heels of a near financial meltdown. We want our regulators to make sure that they have a very comprehensive view of the health and stability of each financial institution. But this proposal would actually extract regulation of the products that these institutions are offering from those that are responsible to make sure that our depository institutions are safe and sound. And so we think that that's actually bifurcating two goals that are really inextricable. So in that regard, particularly when you take into account the fact that the director of this new agency would ultimately be able to move unilaterally, even if the safety and soundness regulators were to find that a regulation could potentially threaten the stability of the system, there's no meaningful way to block that rule. So I think it's really, those are the four primary areas that we're concerned about. So it is, you know, the fact that instead of elevating consumer protection within the federal government, they've actually made consumer protection the primary regulator and the most important regulatory goal. Second, the scope of this is much broader than financial institutions. A lot of small businesses that probably would never otherwise think that they would come under this regulatory regime could be directly regulated. Third is that there really isn't full preemption of state law, and we're very concerned about the state AGs and the authority that they're given under this bill. And the fourth is that we really think that you can't separate safety and soundness of our financial institutions from the products that those institutions are offering. You know, ultimately, unfortunately, in this entire debate about consumer protection, it's been either you support the CFPA or the Bureau of Consumer Financial Protection, or you're clearly anti-consumer, and you're for the status quo. And unfortunately, I think that, you know, there is a much more reasonable middle ground, and that's really ultimately what we're asking of senators right now. We absolutely do want to see consumer protection legislation put forth this year, but given the given all of the stress that the small business community and consumers are currently under, whether it's because the credit markets are tight or because people are nervous about what the healthcare bill is going to do, we think that we need to be very careful in what we're doing here, and a significant overreach that could have unintended consequences is something that we really can't afford. So what we would ask is, you know, the message to our senators needs to be, you know, let's just pull this back. Let's pull it back to a reasonable point. If there's regulatory gaps, let's fill them. If the seven federal financial regulators that were responsible for protecting consumers didn't do their job, then let's hold them accountable and make sure that they're using that authority in the future. Let's make sure that the regulators are well coordinated. So based upon who your federal regulator is, you don't get a pass that someone else might not get through their federal regulator, that they're coordinated and they're holding each other accountable. And for the most part, particularly for these small businesses that aren't primarily engaged in consumer financial products, they really shouldn't be brought under this regulatory regime, particularly when a lot of them are already regulated by the Federal Trade Commission, and the Federal Trade Commission wouldn't actually lose their authority, so there would be duplicate regulation there. So I think these are very reasonable approaches. This bill, as I mentioned, is very much on the fast track. It's possible that it could be brought up for a vote as early as Monday. Chairman Dodd of the Senate Banking Committee and Senator Shelby, the ranking Republican on the Banking Committee, have been trying to work through negotiations basically to make this a bipartisan product. In that scenario, I think we would see a lot of the concerns about the CFPA addressed, where basically you're establishing full preemption, you're narrowing the scope of this agency, you're basically providing some meaningful checks and balances on the director of the agency, and providing the safety and soundness regulator some sort of ability to block a rule that could potentially be bad for the overall system. But unfortunately, I think that there's also a very strong political undercurrent that is pushing this bill along, and that's largely that people are upset that there were some Wall Street abuses. And so I think that in some ways, particularly the Democratic leadership in the Senate is attempting to respond to that and pushing this through. The White House has also been very active in pushing Democrats to move forward in a partisan way. So I think that the most important thing that can happen now is that they work together in a bipartisan way and bring this bill to the floor. And then potentially, if there are things that need to be fixed, we can try to do that through the amendment process on the Senate floor. And I think that's really where we need to ask for help from Senators Pryor and Senators Lincoln, that there are improvements that need to be made here. But we ought to get this right, because the unintended consequences actually would be much more severe for small business owners and consumers in terms of their access to credit than really focusing on a few banks on Wall Street that seem to be the target of this legislation. So why don't I just pause there and see if anyone has any questions. So you've got the Federal Reserve, you've got the FDIC, the OCC, the OTS, HUD. You've got the SEC, the credit union, the NCUA. And who am I forgetting? Is that seven?
Close.
Yeah. So in terms of how they're appointed, there's, you know, variations, obviously.
Do they ever work collectively to do this, or are they all doing?
Well, they do. On consumer protection specifically, it's the Federal Financial Institution Examination Council. It's FIFIEC. And so there is coordination among these regulators through that body. But otherwise, on consumer protection, there is a need there to make sure that these federal regulators are better coordinated. And that's why we would propose a Consumer Protection Council that would do just that. And, you know, I think it even makes sense. Oh, the Federal Trade Commission. That was the one that I was missing. The Federal Trade Commission is general, you know, it's a generalist agency, but largely their mandate is to protect the consumer. So put the FTC at the head of this council so that you can make sure that the consumer protection piece is ultimately the main priority and goal of the council.
Regarding our two senators,
No, it's actually, it passed out of, the interesting thing is it passed out of the Senate Banking Committee last month. As I mentioned, it was 1,400 pages and it passed in 21 minutes. It was purely on a partisan line. So the next step will be the Senate floor. Right now, all 41 Republican senators have expressed that they're unified in their opposition, so they won't have cloture to bring the bill to the floor. But as they continue to make changes, and whether or not Senators Shelby and Dodd can reach negotiation is going to determine really if we'll see that bill. But I think the first procedural motion to try to bring it to the floor will probably come up on Monday night. But I think we're looking at probably 2 to 3 weeks of Senate floor debate on this issue. You know, there is, as I mentioned, there are some really big issues that we're trying to tackle in this bill. Systemic risk, this whole notion of too big to fail. The derivatives piece alone is, you know, some significant fundamental change to a multi-trillion-dollar market. So, you know, the idea that we're just trying to rush this to the floor without addressing everything that needs to be fixed, we think is reason for pause for any senator.
Thank you.